Welcome to another one. Most trappers have heard of COVID and its impact on the mink populations in the United States and the world. Hundreds of mink contracted the virus in Wisconsin, and millions of mink were killed in Denmark as an attempt to prevent the spread. Family businesses in Denmark have been destroyed, and the outlook of world fur prices is uncertain. This video is a quick glance at the impact of COVID on United States mink farms, the Denmark mink farms, and the speculation of COVID's impact on fur prices.
First sign of trouble was that the mink stopped eating, said Hugh Hildebrand, one of the two main mink veterinarians in Wisconsin. Next came coughing and sneezing, lethargy, and labored breathing. 5 to 7 days in, the ranchers thought that most of the mink were going to die. Hildebrand continued with a more positive outlook. The ranchers woke up the next morning, and it just stopped. The mink all started eating, and they ate more than they ever did before. The cause of this was COVID. Wisconsin was a COVID-19 hotspot since late summer, and workers at mink ranches had already tested positive, and the Wisconsin Veterinary Diagnostic Lab in Madison, Wisconsin, confirmed that. The mink caught COVID, most likely from farm workers. It killed hundreds per day, and about 5,500 total on two Wisconsin ranches. It whipped through by coat color. The lighter-coated mink died first because they were bred to bring out the white recessive genes, which caused their immune systems to be more delicate. Wisconsin has yet to find a mink-to-human leap in the virus, and since mink aren't officially considered livestock, Wisconsin won't compensate farmers if mink are killed to prevent disease spread. There are no plans for that to happen. The first infections of U.S. farm mink in Utah in August triggered a national investigation involving wildlife and human health experts across local, state, and federal agencies. Then, in mid-December, a wild mink trapped near a Utah mink farm was confirmed to have the virus, making the first free-range native wild animal confirmed with COVID. Soon after that, two more mink, both Oregon farm escapees, also tested positive. Of all the animals that have been infected with the coronavirus, including dogs, cats, and a few other mammals, the only species to have suffered large-scale casualties so far is the American mink, living on mink ranches. The United States has seen 16 ranch outbreaks since August, 12 in Utah, 2 in Wisconsin, one each in Oregon and Michigan as of late January. Since the first mink got sick on a Dutch ranch in April, millions of the animals have died or been culled on nearly 400 ranches across Denmark, the Netherlands, Sweden, Lithuania, Greece, Italy, France, Spain, and Canada. In early November, Denmark announced its intention to cull 17 million farmed mink. This action was out of fear that a mutated version of the coronavirus might diminish the effectiveness of potential vaccines for humans. Many of these killed mink were buried so sloppily that Denmark has decided it will have to exhume millions of bodies in the spring of 2021 because of possible environmental contamination. COVID was first diagnosed on two mink farms in the Netherlands on the 23rd and 25th of April 2020. But Denmark's decision was not without outrage after images and videos of botched killings and mass mink graves circulated. Farmers spoke to the hardship this would cause them. "We have 65,000 mink. In the coming week, all will be put down," Danish mink farmer Martin Frum said. "This will end our business." Danish Prime Minister Mette Frederiksen apologized for the killings, tearing up, as she called it, a regrettable mistake, and admitting the government did not have the legal jurisdiction to cull so many animals. News of zombie minks pushed up from their shallow and quickly built graves by the gas created from their decomposing bodies has only furthered anger. It seems as though the killing of all mink in Denmark would change the demand and prices of furs dramatically, but Mark Kaufman, a fur merchant in New York City who sells mink coats, says there's no reason for his industry to worry about the outbreaks. "Water rises all," he said. "With furs, if it's not made one place, it's made someplace else. Demand is there, and need for the product is there. If Copenhagen doesn't farm the skins, Russia will. If Russia doesn't, China will. Either way, there is going to be a supply because there is demand." Kaufman, whose family has been in the business since 1870, said his shop is busier this year than last, and customers aren't talking about the minks getting COVID-19. In truth, Denmark's coronavirus-driven mink call has put the fur business in a spin, with industry officials expecting fashion houses such as Louis Vuitton, Dior, and Fendi to snap up fox and chinchilla to fill the gap. The global fur trade, worth more than $22 billion a year, is reeling from Denmark's decision. Worries of a sudden shortage of mink pelts, of which Denmark was a top exporter, have lifted prices by as much as 30% in Asia, the International Fur Federation, IFF, says. The market will strengthen. An increase in prices will help our business in general, Saga Fur's CEO Magnus Jung said of the industry, which has seen years of falling prices. We've already had more requests about foxes. If people see that there is lack of mink, they could consider using something else, Jung said. Euromonitor predicts the value of fur and fur products, both real and faux, to fall by 2.6% in 2021. Copenhagen Fur, a Danish breeder-owned co-op that sold 25 million mink hides last year, or 40% of the global total, is considering selling its brand and other assets after announcing that it would gradually shut down operations over the next 2 to 3 years. CEO Jesper Christensen said he had received expressions of interest from Chinese customers to take over the auction house's brand, which he said could be valued at up to 1 billion Danish crowns, or 163 million US dollars. Copenhagen Fur still plans to sell some 25 million pelts over the next 2 years from Danish farms not infected by the virus, frozen stocks, and foreign animals. Niccolo Ricci, chief executive of Italian luxury designer label Stefano Ricci, which has many clients in Russia and Eastern Europe, said he expected mink prices to increase by up to 50%, but that high-end labels like his would continue to seek top-quality pelts, mainly from U.S. suppliers. The real shortage could come from 2022, but by then we are hoping mink farmers in Canada, Poland, America, and Greece will increase production to replace Danish output, said IFF head Mark Oten. Russia and China are also expected to increase output. People will also be looking at other types of fur. Fox has been very popular for trimmings in parkas, for example. Wild fur is also becoming more popular, as is chinchilla, Oten added. The opportunity in this depressed fur market is the fact that it will force many trappers to find alternative markets for furs. There is a challenge to get creative and seek ways to add value to a product that otherwise is considered a commodity. Some ideas include tanning fur pelts and selling them as decorative wall hangers, making fur clothing like hats and mittens, and other products like blankets and pillows. There are lots of possibilities, but they require hard work in regards to making the products and marketing. In our previous videos, and coming up in future videos, we describe many ways to add value in trapping. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, comment below, and we will do our best to answer. If you have any videos that you would like us to cover, feel free to put that in the comments as well. Please like and share this video, and subscribe to our channel. Again, thanks for watching Outdoor Experiences.